everybody. Thanks for stopping by. My name's Mike McNamara. This is Screen Magazine. Wonderful short made its world premiere here at the Slamdance Film Festival. I managed to track down the wonderful filmmaker, and we're having a great time. So I said, hey, let's just hop on the mic and riff about your wonderful short. It's called Meet My Rapist. And Jessie Kahnweiler, welcome to Screen.
It's so nice to be here in the VIP lounge next to Kanye. With Chris swimming in crystal.
I think we have maybe Luna bars and some year-old Red Bull hovering around.
It's the life.
So tell us.
You're very attractive.
You look good. You have this, you know, wonderful. I mean, I always look for a great title that just jumps out at you. And Meet My Rapist brings me in. Got no idea what the film's about, but I want to see it. So tell me about it.
So Meet My Rapist is a dark comedy, and it's about me running into my rapist at the farmer's market. And after seeing him, it's the first time I've seen him after 8 years. Last time I saw him was when he raped me.
Uh-huh.
So kind of playing on this fantasy of what it would be like to see this guy again, and kind of thinking about the effect that my own personal rapist has had on my life. So I take him to therapy, I take him to meet my parents, you know, I kind of go through all these phases of a relationship. And the film is really about dealing with trauma and how, you know, that, you know, how one processes that and what's the right way and how do we get closure and ultimately the tragedy and comedy and vice versa.
Do you feel like that's kind of a unique approach to it? Because most of the time when we're dealing with this obviously awful, awful issue of sexual assault, we go so dark with it and so emotionally overwrought. This is a way that we're kind of laughing at it, but in a way, you're able to kind of make a personal connection through laughing a little bit. It's a tragedy sometimes.
Absolutely. I mean, I think for me, when I'm the writer, director, and I star in the film, and for me, obviously, it's a very personal film.
I'm so surprised that you wrote it, directed it, and starred
in
it.
Well, I'm broke. What do you want? And I did Crafty.
I was just going to say.
So
your credits.
There you go.
Have those credits.
I'm very good at craft service. That's actually my best skill. I always know what to get. Okay. So
yes,
when I was sitting down to write the film, I didn't set out to make a comedy. For me, I was just trying to kind of deal with this issue of, you know what, I was raped 8 years ago and I'm still not over it and it's really frustrating, and this dude, I knew him for 48 minutes and he's, you know, I haven't seen him again, I don't even remember his face, and he's had such a profound impact on my life. And kind of when I was thinking about my experience in trying to overcome my rape, there's so many comedic moments, you know, how society deals with rape. You know, for instance, I told some of my girlfriends and they're like, but were you really raped?
Right.
You know, that was the first question. You know
right.
what I mean? Where some people would go, oh my God, honey, like you need to, oh my God, I bet you got to swear off, you know, dick forever, you know, men forever, you know,
right.
And then other people would be like, but you weren't really raped, you know, it was fine. So just kind of looking
at. Do you have bruises? Are you, you know, bleeding all over
that's
the
place? That's what I'm
it's
saying.
It's so hilarious how
and,
this.
And this whole idea of like, you know, what my rapist did for a living, you know, he was a motorbike driver, and it's being like, well, you know, I wish he would have had a better career. You know, all these really absurd things that my brain, listen, naturally does. I'm not trying to poke fun at anything, and I'm certainly not trying to say that rape is funny, but I tend to live my life like a comedy, so telling it in that way felt the truest way for me to tell the story was through comedy.
Last thing, guys, we're talking with Jessie Kahnweiler about her short film out here at Slamdance called Meet My Rapist. Did this have an impact on your life? Did this help you kind of move on from it?
Listen.
You know, because this guy's kind of put a big, you know, I don't want to say wrecked your life for a little while, but it's a big fucking problem. And has this helped you kind of move on?
It's definitely helped me with the process of closure and how you kind of deal with tragedy. And listen, I don't think I will ever, ever fully be over this, but making the film helped me realize that that's okay. And I think opening up the dialogue has been really empowering for me, and being able to connect with other people that have also gone through this and really just opening the conversation has really made me realize, like, you know, this film is so much bigger than me. And it's a personal story, but it's those personal stories that really, when you can connect to people on a universal level, that is what I call a filmgasm.
Damn right. I love it. We'll end it with that. Jessie, thanks for hanging out with me on screen.
Back to the crystal.
Hey, Meet My Rapist is the short. You can check it out online right now. We got links to it right here at Screen Mag. My name is Mike McNamara. Thanks for hanging out. I'll talk to you again soon.